So, welcome back, everybody. Ladies and gentlemen, artists, scientists, I know this is the moment you've all been waiting for. So Dave Green's arrived. He is in the building. I've been told that he has the radicalism of Jeremy Corbyn, the dress sense of Andy Burnham, and the dance moves of Liz Kendall. Oh, no, sorry, I read that wrong. It's the dress sense of Jeremy Corbyn. The dance moves of Andy. Yeah, anyway. So without any further ado, let's welcome Dave. He's come from a very busy day talking about Syrian refugees, and he's going to tell us why everybody, not just those from Syria, but everybody should move to Bradford. So with a big round of applause, here's Dave.
Why is it I feel a funding bid coming on? I was warned that I was going to get that sort of introduction, and I actually regard myself as more radical than Jeremy Corbyn, I have to say. And more radical than Yvette Cooper and Andy Burnham and Liz Kendall, just to cover all my bases, depending on who wins. But I've burnt my boats many a time within the Labour Party. I'll just wait for it to come back to me. I'm delighted to be here and to welcome you to this great city. Bradford has innovated, has led the way, and has been at the forefront of social, scientific, and cultural change ever since it has been a place of settlement. And it's, I think, the example of Born in Bradford, which has now been running for 8 years, as I recall, is yet another example about how we are leading the way and how we are leading the way together. The thing that first strikes me about your welcoming banner there is find out how 13,000 Bradford families are helping push forward our knowledge of science. And I think that that is the key thing, both about Born in Bradford and about Bradford itself. It is the community coming together with scientists, with academics, with all the professions to help advance human knowledge. And the people that I first want to thank are those 13,000 families. Because whilst I think it started off as, it's quite exciting, it's quite fun, it'll be quite interesting, I think the fact that they've stuck with it, by and large, for 8 years, with all, to use a bit of lazy language, the prodding and poking and intrusion of the scientific community into their lives, the fact that they've stuck with it shows their commitment to the whole project. And the fact that the academics and the scientists and the professions have stuck with it over those 8 years, I think is a testament to their sense of belonging to a great community that is Bradford, and to their sense of pride in being part of this unique piece of work. Because it is a piece of work, it's not an experiment, it's not about social engineering. It is about the pursuit of knowledge to help not just the people in Bradford, but the people across the world. And I hope that from what you've heard today, you'll understand the importance of this work and how it can be transferred outside the boundaries of our city. I am delighted that Bradford Council is learning from the outcome of Born in Bradford. Those of you who have the joy of reading our local newspaper, the Bradford Telegraph and Argus, and if you haven't read today, do go out and buy a copy because they need the sales. But more importantly is front page story, however gaudy the headline is based really on research that comes from Born in Bradford about the environmental effects of emissions from diesel and petrol engines, and has started a debate in Bradford. It's been through Health and Wellbeing Board, it's been through the Council's Executive, That information is feeding into the policies that we are trying to pursue to actually cut down on air pollution, because we have even harder evidence than is available nationally to actually look at the effect of emissions on child development. And it is something that we as a council and our partners can actually do something about. Sometimes the science that comes from projects can be a bit esoteric, but what we're finding with Born in Bradford is that there are practical things that we can do, because the information is presented to us in a way that even a politician who only just scraped his chemistry O level can understand and can act on. So I wish Born in Bradford well, not just for the next couple of years, but for the next 10 or 15 years, because the information that we are getting from Born in Bradford is really helping us understand the challenges that we face now, but the challenges that we know we're going to face in the future. And we have that information and that store of knowledge available to us so that we can plan ahead. What we do know is that outside of London, Bradford is the youngest city in the United Kingdom. It has a population that is growing, and it has a young population. That is why we were so committed to the concept of Born in Bradford when it was first put to us, and why we remain committed to it. Because if we do not understand what is going on in our young population, we have no opportunity to make life better for them. And we need to do that. Those of you who have come from outside of Bradford, or perhaps outside the Yorkshire area, may have come with an idea about what Bradford is like from the media. I hope that from your stay here, you'll have recognised that we are making strides forward to regain where this city should be, which is at the forefront of British urban development. To do that, we need to have a healthy population. We need to have social services that term covers to deliver to the needs of the local community, using the information we have from Born in Bradford and marrying it with local social policy, and also putting pressure on national and regional governments, we can actually really make a difference to the people that I represent and the people that the other councillors represent. That is what we are determined to do. And I hope that from today's debates and discussions, you'll take away some of the knowledge that we've been able to pass on to you so that you can put that into practice in your own communities, in your own cities, in your own institutions. I hope that some of you are staying for the British Science Festival, either for the whole of it or at least make some of it. If you're not, I hope that you will come back to Bradford, either in your professional positions or just for a visit. If you do, I can assure you that you will continue to see the partnership work that Born in Bradford has borne, continuing to take this district forward. And so I'd just like to thank you all for your attendance today. I hope you found it interesting. I hope you've enjoyed your stay in Bradford. And one last thing, going back to where we started, if you happen to be a Labour Party member and you haven't posted your ballot yet, do so now. Thank you.
Right, that's it. What a positive way to end. I can't say anything better than that. You know, what a vision for the future, working together. It's great testimony of what Dave's talking about, of the council, the health service, social services, and researchers working together to change the city. So I haven't got anything else to say. I've been nipping in and out of all the different presentations, trying to get a sense of what's going on. I'm sure you'll agree about the fantastic quality of our presenters, of our scientists today. It really has been amazing. I've just been really stunned. So if we can do the usual and show our appreciation to all the speakers today. We've got some feedback forms, and as I said at the beginning, we do read these, so give us some feedback, not about the sandwiches, which I'm sure you'll agree were delicious, but if you could give us your feedback, ways that we can improve it for next time. Follow us on Twitter. Well, it's not on there, but you can see it on the conference form. Follow Dave on Twitter, Dave for Wibsey. And look at our website, keep up to date, keep involved. You know, this is a crowdsourced project. We rely on everybody to be part of Born in Bradford, so do keep closely involved. Now, most importantly, today, while the people who've been presenting have spent the last 6 years working on data for their presentations, two of the individuals, Laura and Liz, have also spent the last 6 years preparing for today. And they really have done a fantastic job. So I'd like, in particular, where are they? Liz, Laura? Are they here? Laura, Liz. Come down. Come on down. Yeah, it is. And the first prize is a dance with Dave. Second prize, two dances. Yeah. So, come up here and let everybody give you another round of applause for doing such a fantastic job.
Thank you very much. Hope you've all had a great day. I think it's all gone pretty well. It was very much a team effort.
Definitely.
Yeah. So thank you to all the BIB team
and volunteers.
All the new interns that have come along to help us and the student volunteers.
And the old interns who are
some. Yes, and
the
old interns. Yes, Amy and Natasha.
I think everybody deserves a round of applause after that.
Definitely.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. So stay in touch, and we'll see you at the Family Festival next year and the next Science Festival the year after that. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh.